Hey guys, it's Katie. Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to a new vlog. So I'm excited about today's video. I hope you guys are too. As you can tell from the title, I'm going to be reading other booktubers slash authortubers slash YouTubers books and making a reading vlog dedicated for it. So this vlog isn't gonna have any spoilers in it. So if you haven't read these books, no worries. I've been in kind of a slump with my content lately and I just haven't been super excited about a lot of the videos that I've been making. So I was going through my subscriptions and I was just kind of paying attention to which videos that I tended to click on, the ones that I was enjoying the most. And I've really been enjoying people's like secret TBR kind of videos. And I was like, okay, well, what kind of books am I interested in right now? What kind of books have I been excited to read? Because I've also kind of been in a reading slump. I was like, you know what? There's a lot of books by my peers essentially that I've been meaning to read and I just haven't gotten to them yet. So maybe that would be a fun video. Maybe you're also curious about these books. So with that said, I've talked about this before. I love making myself uncomfortable. Obviously my goal with this video is to read the book and give you my honest reaction and review for each of the books and what I really think about them. But the authors of these books are my peers, whether I know them or not. Some of them I actually do talk to and I know. Some of them I know follow my channel or I follow their channel. So that's not going to get in the way of me being honest about these books, but if you came here for like a tea spill rant style video, that's not what this is gonna be. Not that there's anything wrong with those kind of videos, but that's not what we're doing here. So as for the books that I'm going to be reading for this video, because I've been in kind of a reading slump and I didn't want to overwhelm myself by some long list of books, I chose three. We're gonna start with three. I might make this a series and have some videos in the future and we'll go by threes. So if there are any books by authortubers, booktubers, YouTubers that you want to see me do in a future video, feel free to leave those down below in the comments. Odds are, honestly, if it's not in this video, it might be because I've already read it. The best way to tell is you can check my Goodreads account because I update that pretty religiously. So all of the books that I've read are on there. And if you don't already follow me on Goodreads, I'll have the link down below if you'd like to. So I downloaded a ton of samples onto the Kindle app on my phone for options. And there were so many books that I wanted to read, but the three that I've chosen for this video are one, The Stars We Steal by Alexa Dunn. This book just came out, I think, last month. And anytime a YA sci-fi book comes out, I get really excited because it's a bit of a struggling genre. It's kind of a rare breed. And I've heard this book described as sort of the Bachelorette in space, which you guys know I'm a sucker for The Bachelor and The Bachelorette, so this sounds right up my alley. So our main character is an 18-year-old named Leo, and engagement season is in the air, so she's looking to see which bachelor is going to save her family from financial ruin. But her childhood best friend and first love, Elliot, returns. He was the one who got away. So basically, this seems to be full of tropes that I love. I'm really excited about it. I read Alexa's debut novel, Brightly Burning, last year, and I really liked it. So I'm really looking forward to read her new book. I love her videos, and honestly, this book just sounds like it's gonna be right up my alley, so I'm really excited for it. By the way, I'll have links to the channels of all of the YouTubers down below if you don't already follow them. So then the second book that we're going to be reading is Song of the Dryad by Natalia Lee. I've heard this one described as a cozy contemporary fantasy. So our main character's name is Charlotte. She's 16 years old, and she's still haunted by an encounter she had 8 years ago, a run-in with a fairy beast. So basically, she can see fairies. She's pretending they don't exist. She's focused on graduating from high school and perfecting her audition piece. Oh, so I think she plays the violin, but then her mom goes missing, kidnapped by the fairies that haunt the forest behind her home. So I think this book is about her going to search for her mom and then realizing that she's more connected to the fairy world than she realized. I'm excited for this one. I always thought that I didn't like fairy books for the longest time, and recently I've been reading like a lot of fairy books and I've liked all of them. I was like, oh, maybe I do like these, and I just didn't know. I also really love books that have strong familial relationships, so if this character has like a really strong connection with her mom, I know I'm gonna like that. I've seen really good reviews for this one as well. I love Natalia's videos, and I tried to do a little bit of variation with the genres of these books as well. So then the final book on our TBR for this video, this was hard. I had so many to choose from, but I ended up going with Sacrifice Me by Sarah Cannon. So this is the first book, and it was originally like a serial, so I think it has two parts to it, and I think it's like a new adult urban fantasy. Again, I love Sarah Cannon's videos, and I did start her other series last year. I read the first three books in her Shadow Demons saga. So this is set in the same world but follows different characters, and I don't think you have to have read the first series to read this one. I haven't finished that series, so I think we're gonna be okay. Yeah, our main character Frankie is 21. She receives a note with her mother's nickname for her on her birthday, but her mother went missing 3 years ago. And the series has vampires, demons, witches, shifters, all of the paranormal creatures in it, so it sounds like it's gonna be really fun. Those are three books that we're gonna start with. I will update you as I read them, and I'll have links to all of the books as well as all all of the channels for the authors down below if you'd like to go check those out.
So I've started the first book. I decided to start with Sacrifice Me by Sarah Cannon. I was expecting the book to be really short because all of the books in her Shadow Demon saga so far were really short. But I think this, like season one, book one, is two books combined. So it's like 475 pages, but it's two books. So I've read 45 pages so far and I'm 9% in. Not that you really care about the exact numbers. I'm still at the beginning, but my initial thoughts are I can already see a difference because like I said, I read her first series last year. There's a noticeable improvement in the storytelling and the writing so far. So that's a really pleasant surprise. I was at nannying, just like reading it on my phone, and I was immediately sucked in. The kids were like, let's go jump on the trampoline. And I was like, ah, because I just wanted to keep reading it. So that's a good sign. Okay, so I was mistaken. This bind up includes 6 episodes, and so there's different chapters in the episodes. There was 11 chapters in episode 1. I just finished episode 1.
We've moved on to episode 2.
I'm not sure how I feel about the format and how it's like split into episodes, but I'm interested by the story. Definitely gonna keep reading. I'm really glad that I have the whole bind up and I can read it all together, because if I had only read that first part, which is like 60 pages, I would have been really not satisfied by that ending, and even just like the arc of that story, it doesn't really feel complete on its own. So I'm glad that I have them all and I can read them all together. So I'm still reading Sacrifice Me by Sarah Cannon. I've made it 36% of the way through. I'm on page 174 and I'm starting to struggle a little bit, enough so that I'm thinking about DNFing the book, which is so disappointing. The problem is there's things about it that I really like, and I am curious about what's going on in the world and everything, and I want to know how it all pans out, but then there's pieces of it that I just really don't like, and it's kind of ruining it for me. Like, it'll be fine and then we'll go into a scene that's just not fine. It's like there's certain things that I think she writes really well, like there are scenes with her friends and stuff that I really like, but as soon as it's with her and the love interest, it just gets like, I don't want to say corny or cheesy because I feel like that's mean, but I don't know how else to explain it. Like, this main character's relationship with the guy, I just like can't take it seriously. I think in part because it's like an insta love kind of situation, but also like he's like touching her cheek like every 2 seconds and carrying her everywhere, and they're just so intense and they're strangers, and I'm just like, if someone was touching me like that and I didn't know him, I would just be really creeped out. It's hard because it's this like paranormal world and we're following a main character who obviously doesn't know anything about it or her history and stuff, and it's just hard. It's not even this particular book's problem. I have this problem with most books in the genre, is the moment where they find out about the world and they're learning about it. It's just so like corny to me. There's literally a line, this isn't really a spoiler if you know what her books are about, it's like, you're a witch, and all I can think of is that scene in Harry Potter, you're a wizard, Harry. There is parts of it that I'm really enjoying, and what I was hoping for, because this is a new adult book and our main character is 21, is that it would feel older, because one of the problems that I had with her previous series was it just felt like it was too young for me, and this one is still just reading really young to me, which isn't, you know, a problem of the book, it's just a problem with my enjoyment so far. So I'm gonna give it at least, I think I'm gonna give it to halfway and see if I wanna continue reading on from there before I decide if I'm gonna DNF it or not.
Hello from the future. You will recognize this outfit in a future clip in this video, but I realized that I never officially gave the announcement that I've decided to DNF this first book. I kept trying to push through it, and then I realized that my enjoyment level or my thoughts on it weren't going to change even if I did make it to the end. So I made it to exactly halfway through. I pushed to 50%. And it's not like it's a bad book. I just was having a really hard time with a few specific elements. Like I was saying, I was hoping it was gonna read older, but it was reading younger than I would have liked. And the relationship or romance in particular, which was slowly being brought to the forefront, so I knew it was gonna become the focus of the story. It was, not only was it like insta-lovey, but there was just like no development leading up to it. And I went from really liking our main character to just like trying not to roll my eyes at her because she was being so melodramatic. Like, she just met this guy, she doesn't know him, and then something goes wrong, and then she's like, I should have protected myself from love. You've known him for like 48 hours. Like, what are you talking about? So I can definitely see why people like this book. And like I said, I have so much respect for Sarah Cannon, and I've tried a lot of her books before in the past. They were the first 3 books in her first series. And I just think I may be trying to read them at the wrong time in my life. I feel like I would have liked them more when I was younger. I really like the world in these books. I feel like they have so much potential. I'm just having a hard time with the development of the relationships between the characters, and it's just pulling me out of the book. I go like a chapter at a time and something in every chapter like pulls me out, so I have to stop and then I go back, and it just like keeps disrupting the momentum of me trying to read the book, you know? So unfortunately, I've just decided to give up on this one. We're now moving on to book two. I'm actually already on page 50, so I'm 12% in. For The Stars We Steal, I'm reading the ebook on Scribd. And so I just made it to chapter 5 and I'm already liking it. It feels very similar to her first book. I think I'm gonna like this one more than the last one, which is kind of why I chose to jump to this one, because I had higher hopes for this one. I think this is a persuasion retelling? I could be wrong. But basically, what we've learned so far is our main character, Leo, has this past with this guy, Elliot. And she's clearly not over him, and he's clearly not over her, but they're like expressing it differently. And he comes back into her life after 3 years. Something might be going on between him and her younger sister, which is just like, oh, there's gonna be so much drama. And then also they're on these spaceships. So we're really exploring like the class struggles. Basically, they have this engagement season where all the people higher up in society come to mingle to find people to marry. Meanwhile, the other like half of the population is poor and they don't have enough food and they're just being neglected. So I'm assuming it's really gonna focus on the romance, but I'm also very interested in the whole world and the political aspect of it. So yeah, I'm about 50 pages in. I will update you once I get a little bit further. I keep choosing the days when I'm looking just super rough to update you. So I'm still reading The Stars We Steal. I'm currently 45% of the way through, so I'm on page 171. I'm enjoying it. I'm liking the writing. I'm definitely gonna finish it, not even thinking of DNFing this one. It's interesting because I've seen so many comparisons of it calling it The Bachelorette in space, and it kind of is, but it's more of, funnily enough, I kind of think of it as like Sorority Rush, where you have to choose each other. But anyway, the thing that I'm having a hard time with is I know this is gonna turn into a romance between our two main characters, and the guy, I just like want to punch him in the face. And I'm trying to like calm myself down and be like, he's this age, like of course he's gonna be immature, like, but also this guy's a freaking idiot. So he and this girl were together. They were engaged, like they were in love, and then she ended up having to break it off because of money and because of her family, and everyone talked her out of it. And she was a teenager when this happened too. And this happened 3 years ago, and then he goes off and he hasn't seen her in 3 years, and he comes back. It's been 3 years, and he comes back and he wants, his words exactly, he wants to make her suffer. He wants to make her jealous. He has this whole like revenge plot against her. One, to do that at all is just shitty. Like, get over it. You're an adult now. It's been 3 years. You should be over it by now. And also just wanting to get revenge on someone like that, it's just shitty. And especially the way that he goes about it, he's flirting with her relatives. He's going after her little sister and her cousin. And I'm just like, I want to punch this guy in the freaking face. Also, I find that so unattractive. Like, if I were her and this guy that I used to be in love with, if a guy who claimed to be in love with you enough to want to be engaged to you would then turn around to treat you like that when you decided not to marry him, like, if he can't take rejection and this is his response to that, like, why would you want anything to do with this guy? So I'm having a hard time with the book just because I feel like it's gonna be them coming back together and that's what we're getting towards. And like, I don't want them to. I want her to walk away from this idiot. Sorry, I just need to get that off my chest. I was feeling very passionate about it. But other than that, I'm enjoying the book. And that's not even like an issue with the book, especially because this is a retelling of a different story. I just hate his character. And he's like kind of got called out on his bullshit, but like everyone is still vying for him. Ugh, not a fan. Hello? Oh my gosh, what is going on? So I just finished reading The Stars We Steal and I liked it. I liked it a lot, actually. I feel like my enjoyment of it is pretty on par with my enjoyment of her first book, Brightly Burning, which I think I gave like a 3.75 stars to, and I just rounded it up to 4 stars on Goodreads. So I'm kind of leaning towards giving this one a 4 stars as well. My immediate impressions is I'm happy with the way it ended. The ending did feel a little bit rushed for me, and I was surprised because Scribd was telling me I had like 40 pages left, but it was just because it had an excerpt of her other book in the end, so I wasn't prepared for it to end what it did. I got over my intense frustration. I was like really frustrated reading this book for the whole like middle part of it. I got over it, but it made me like actively angry reading the middle part, which doesn't mean there's anything wrong with the book or is the problem of the book. I actually kind of look at that as a good thing. I feel like the like kiss of death for any book is for readers to not care. and to not have any emotional connection, to not care what happens to the characters, to not be invested. And so whenever I get like really emotional about a book, whether it's I'm really happy, I'm really sad, I'm really frustrated, I'm really angry, I immediately, no matter what emotion that is, think that's a good thing if a book can make me feel something to a strong degree. So my intense frustration, I think of as a good thing, even though it was really unpleasant while I was reading it. So yeah, we'll go over my thoughts probably tomorrow after I've had a little bit of time to process the whole book.
Hello. So I realized that I told you in the last clip, I'll update you tomorrow on what my thoughts are, and it's not tomorrow, but I'm still gonna update you on what my overall thoughts for this book were. So yes, I ended up giving The Stars We Steal a 4 out of 5 stars. I really, really enjoyed it. It was a really solid romance read. It's predominantly a romance. It is set in space. It is a sci-fi, but it's more so a romance. So I think if you go in with that expectation, you'll enjoy it. Definitely a solid read. I'm glad that I read it.
Hello, this is Editing Katie here, and I realized that I didn't say everything I wanted to say in the wrap-up for this book. I was just reminded while I was editing the earlier clips how I was talking about how I was super interested in the political aspect, and I just did want to mention that while this is super focused on the romance, and we do kind of touch on the political stuff, it doesn't really go into that stuff as much as I would have liked. So I felt like that area, I don't even want to say it was lacking, because I just really don't feel like that was the focus of the book. I was just personally more interested in learning more about the world and everything that was going on. So yeah, just know that with this book, you're really going to focus on the romance and the relationship between all of the different characters.
Now we're going to move on to book number 3. So book number 3 is going to be Song of the Dryad by Natalia Lee. This one is supposed to be like a cozy contemporary fantasy with fae and fairies and stuff in it. I've actually already started the book. I've read about the first 20% or so, and my thoughts so far, I'm really enjoying it so far. I'm getting very strong like Spiderwick Chronicle vibes from it. If you read those books, I know those are probably old and people don't even know what they are anymore. Or if you saw the movie, I'm reading it on my Kindle and I literally made a note in there somewhere like strong AF Spider-Man Chronicle vibes. I had a little bit of trouble getting into it at first, but honestly, I don't know if that's the book's fault or my fault for trying to read it while I was nannying and I had like kids like screaming around me and stuff. So since I've been home and been able to read in peace and quiet, I've enjoyed it a lot more so far. So yeah, I'm about 20% in. I'm hoping to make a lot more progress today, so I will update you when I have some more to update you on, but I definitely have high hopes for this one.
So, hello, I've been reading Song of the Dryad. I am now a little over halfway. I am 53% of the way through, and I'm enjoying it so far. I think it's very cute and charming. It's taking me a little bit longer to finish this than I thought I was going to. One, I think it's like a relatively long book by itself, and then it's also just slower paced. That's not necessarily like a problem with the book or anything, but compared to a lot of the books that I've been reading like a lot of thrillers and stuff. It's just something that like, I'll pick it up, I'll read a chapter or two, I'm enjoying it, but then I'm like happy setting it down and coming back to it the next day. So I've just been going through it like a little bit at a time. It's not super fast paced. And like I said, it's very like cozy, charming, kind of reminds me of like a, not a sitcom TV show, but you know, like the, what is it? Like Lifetime TV shows. Do you know what I'm talking about? Kind of feels like that. If you've ever seen the show, The Good Witch, it kind of gives me those similar vibes. And then same with like the Spiderwick Chronicles. All of this is to say, is I'm enjoying it. I like the atmosphere of it, but the plot itself isn't super fast paced, so it's just taking me a little bit longer to finish it. The one thing that's really annoying me right now is, so the plot is that the main character's mom goes missing and her best friend, this girl. So Charlotte, our main character, doesn't tell her best friend that her mom is missing at first. It's a complicated situation and she's still like processing it herself. Like, I find it totally understandable that she isn't going around telling everyone that her mom's missing yet. So then when her best friend finds out about it, she gets really mad that Charlotte didn't tell her and starts and just like stops speaking to her, and they're like in a fight about it. And I'm just like, are you seriously making the disappearance of your friend's mom about you? And getting mad about it? And then like Charlotte feels bad about it and I just can't wrap my head around it. I'm like, wouldn't you be like, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry, let me know if there's anything I can do to help you in this difficult time, not this difficult time that you are having is inconveniencing me. Oh, I find that wild. So yeah, like I said, I'm a little over halfway. I'll probably update you again once I finish the book. Hello everybody, we have come to the final update of the vlog. So I just finished reading Song of the Dryad and I'm conflicted on what I want to rate it. I feel like I go back and forth every year on whether or not I want to continue to give star ratings to the books that I read. And honestly, the only reason why I've continued to do so is just to kind of give myself some sort of idea of what I thought about a book, so when I look back on it, I can remember what I thought about it, because I forget. I read so many books in a year. By the time I get to the end of the year, I don't remember what I liked and what I didn't like or how much I liked something. But then there's certain books that are harder to rate for me than others, and this is one of those books. I'm swinging somewhere between like 3 and 4 stars, so it's not like it's not a drastic difference or anything like that. I enjoyed it. I have a lot of things about it that I really, really liked. I had some issues with it as well, a lot of which have to do with like specific things towards like the middle and the end of the book that I can't talk about without spoiling it. So basically, pros. I really think she did an awesome job with the atmosphere. This book was super like cozy and atmospheric. Like I was saying at the beginning, it really reminded me of the Spiderwick Chronicles, and I really liked the world building and the fairies and how charming it was. It was really cute. I really enjoyed that aspect of it. And I read so many dark books because I really like thrillers, so I'm always reading things where people are getting like murdered and stuff, and this one was just kind of cute. It still has some like relatively dark or like serious things happening in it, but it was just a totally different tone than most books that I've read lately, like a lighthearted kind of tone, and I actually liked that about the book. There were some things that just did not make sense to me. I don't want to call them plot holes because I wouldn't necessarily classify them as plot holes, but there were just some things that just did not make any sense to me, and it was just like in the back of my mind the whole time reading it, like waiting to see if like something would be revealed to like have it make more sense. But there's just some things that just didn't line up for me, and that really got under my skin. I made some notes within the ebook to remind myself of things I wanted to talk about. I liked our characters. What was hard is a big part of this book is that her mom goes missing, and so she's going through all of this to try and save her mom. And we don't see a scene with her and her mom before that happens. Like, we never actually interact with her mom on the page. And so obviously anyone's mom going missing is hard, but I just kind of wish we would have gotten a better feel for her mom's character before all of this happened. We already talked about the thing with her best friend and how that annoyed me. There were some things that happened where I felt like it was almost convenient, or it just wasn't properly set up ahead of time, like how things worked, how this world worked. And so it would just, like, this information was revealed at a time that it was just like, oh, convenient. Like, oh, by the way, this works like this, which makes this possible. You know, so those kind of tripped me up a little bit. And there were just some things, like the logic of some of the fairy characters, it didn't line up. It didn't make sense. And also, this fairy character, she's like buddy-buddy with her and describing her as being like super nice and super kind and stuff. I'm like, this chick literally just like is kidnapping people that you love, but she's so nice. Like, she couldn't have just asked you for a favor and been like, hey, we need your help, can you help me? And then done it on good faith. But no, she needed to hold your mom hostage, but she's still like a nice, kind fairy. I don't know, I just thought that was kind of funny. Overall, I really, really enjoyed it. It's very different than pretty much anything else that I've read so far this year. If you like fantasy, especially contemporary fantasy, I think you'll really enjoy this. Maybe like a 3.5 out of 5 stars? I don't know. I have a hard time. There's just like so many factors that go into rating a book for me, like my enjoyment level, the quality of the book, and then comparing it to other books that I've rated that same rating before, you know? Either way, that was the last book for this video. So yeah, I would love to hear down below in the comments if you've read any of these books and what you thought of them, or feel free to leave suggestions down below in the comments of which books I should read next. And let me know if you like this format of video. It's kind of fun to try something new. If you're new here, maybe think about subscribing. I put up at least 2 new videos every single week. I'd love to have you stick around. My book is coming out in June. It's called The Anti-Virginity Pact. You can add it on Goodreads. You can pre-order it. All my links are down below, and I'll just see you guys in my next video very, very soon.
So hit me. So hit me. So hit me. First a confession. With you, I feel a connection. With